Hello everybody, my name is Konstantinos Kyritopoulos, and in this video we are talking about research approach. There are plenty of approaches that we can take in research. Some of the times, the research approach is dictated by the research itself. However, most of the times, it is the researcher that needs to pick a specific approach. And the main thing is the classification, where we fit in different kind of classifications in research. One kind of classification would be exploratory descriptive or explanatory. So, in exploratory research, we would like, for instance, to know if building information modeling is used in Australian companies. In descriptive research, we might want to know how many Australian companies are using building information modeling. So, it's a kind of describing what is happening. And in explanatory, what we are going to do is answer a question, why? So why is building information modeling used by Australian companies? Exploratory, explore what is happening. Descriptive, describe what is happening. And explanatory, explain why what we observe is happening. This is one kind of research classification. Another one is relating to what we call the research philosophy. So, in this kind of classification, we have two extremes. One of them is positivism, and the other is interpretivism. In positivism, we assume that there is a real answer to what is happening, to what we are researching on. So, positivism is very much applied in natural sciences. We are looking for specific answers, how things are working in our world, and usually there can't be much debate when we find we have our findings. But interpretivism is usually appearing in social sciences. In social sciences, plenty of times, there is no right or wrong answer. It is only how people perceive what is happening. And with interpretivism, we acknowledge that, and we are practically researching on the interpretations of people about certain phenomena. In between the two, we have what we call realism. Realism would stand between the two, acknowledging that there is one part that it is knowledge that we can obtain and it is not questionable, while on the other hand, there will be some parts of this research that will be most towards interpretivism, which practically means that there will be different perceptions about what is happening. It's a kind of merging between the two. And this is the second kind of classification that we can do. One other very basic kind of classification is whether we are doing deduction or induction. And in order to answer this question, we need to go through the triangle of research. So in the triangle of research, we will have our data, we will have analysis, and, of course, we'll have the theory. In induction, what is happening is that we are starting from collecting the data without really making any prior assumption of what we're going to find. We get the data, from the data we do the analysis, And from the analysis, we come up with kind of a theory of what is happening, our interpretation after the analysis of the data that we gathered. And this would be the induction. So induction, straight lines. On the other hand, we have deduction. In deduction, we are taking a theory and we are trying to either validate it or reject it. So we are starting from the theory. The theory is giving the hypothesis, the assumptions, what we are expecting to find. Then we collect the data. And after having collected the data, we do the analysis. And this will be the deduction. Dotted line. So the basic three kind of classifications would be exploratory, descriptive, or explanatory. The other one would be the research philosophy, which is positivism, interpretivism, or maybe realism. And there are plenty of other differentiations that fine-tune exactly how we perceive research. And of course, deduction or induction, which is practically dictated from how we are approaching the research triangle. If we're starting from data, moving towards a theory, or if we're starting a theory, moving towards analysis. Good luck.